This time, we meet a family who are bursting at the seams.
There's going to be four children wanting just the one space.
Calm.
Come on, guys.
And feeling like they have nowhere to turn.
Is it really worth it? Is that what we actually want to do?
There's no easy fix.
What about numbers of bedrooms, though?
Numbers of bedrooms is not something I can change.
So compromise is the only option.
We are 1 mile from home.
I'm impressed.
Today, we're in the East Midlands, in the historic city of Nottingham.
And I'm already getting a head start on the competition with some area research. Hello.
Good morning.
I'm seeing some lovely houses.
OK.
Hills, views.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly, I could be in San Francisco.
Steady on. I've got a fun fact about Nottingham.
Okie doke, what's your fun fact?
It used to be called Snottingus.
I think you'll find it was called Snottingham. Perhaps you should stop there.
It's absolutely...
You diced with death when it comes to Nottingham, Bill.
I know, we mustn't get thrown out before we've even got there.
I'm calling it Nottingham, OK? And that's an end
I'm
to it.
I'm calling it Snottingus.
Honestly, Phil, I think you'd better keep your fun facts to yourself today.
We'll see.
We're here to meet clothing designer Lexi and her IT consultant husband, Ed, who met as flatmates 12 years ago.
So I actually moved up to Nottingham just randomly for a job, started in a house share, and I think about 6 months later met you, and then we got together.
Pretty quickly.
Pretty quickly, yeah.
Since then, they've become a family of six.
With 6-year-old Nico, Xanthi, who's 4, and 15-month-old twins, Lani and Phoenix, they're quickly outgrowing their 4-bed 1920s semi, which they bought just 4 years ago. And Ed thinks it's time to move on.
So I want to list this house because it's getting small. The house itself won't cater for a scaling sort of family. Not that we're having any more children, but as they get bigger, you know, we're walking over each other in the kitchen.
The fourth bedroom is currently my office, but it's very, very cold. It's not really a viable bedroom. And
I'm getting annoyed with things like the parking outside.
Despite the growing tensions, Nottingham local Lexi loves their home's character and can still see a future here.
Give me that foot. The reason that I love this house is because it's got a really nice flow to it. It's bright. It's just a homely home. Like, we brought it with the intention of doing something to it, and we've never done it. So it's a case of eventually getting on to doing that.
But the thought of extending the house enough to fit their current needs is proving quite overwhelming.
Literally, before we even moved here, we had plans to, you know, we'll knock down that wall, we'll do this, we'll do that. But every time we come to do some work, we think, oh, is it really worth it? Is that what we actually want to do? Will that actually give me what we want? And it's like, we've gone through that process now for so long, for say 3 years, that, you know, the fact that we've not changed the carpet in the front room because we were always considering that, oh, we'll have to rip it all up anyway to do some more electrics, to do this X, Y, Z. We've just been in that constant state.
The current layout has a large lounge diner along one side of the house and a small family area leading to the kitchen at the back. Then upstairs, they currently use 3 bedrooms for sleeping, with Nico and Xanthi sharing one small room, the twins in the tiny box room, and the 4th room at the back, which is the coldest room in the house, kept as an office for Ed to work from home. But the biggest bugbear for all the family is that there's only 1 bathroom in the whole house.
The children fight. It's whoever can get to the toilet first, or whoever we say has to go first, depending on who's been needing it the longest. And the thought that we've got twins and there's going to be 4 children wanting just the one space, I think that's going to be a problem as they do get older.
So even though their house is a decent size, there just aren't enough rooms for this family of six.
It just means that there's no calm in any space because they do use the entire house as their playground.
I'll make them go around here.
And the long-standing debate over whether to love or list is taking its toll on Lexi and Ed.
It's caused a lot of friction, and especially when you've got 4 kids to worry about as well. You know, you don't want to have to be constantly going over the different points of why we should stay, why we should go, why we should stay. Oh, but there's a baby crying. Oh, I've got to do the dinner. I've got 10 piles of washing to do. So, yeah, it's just exhausting more than anything.
I can see why they've called us. Remember Pip, on your best behaviour.
When am I not?
So, who wants to love, who wants to list?
I want to list it because we've got four children. It's not big enough now. I don't think it's going to be big enough if we do anything to it. And certainly as they get older, then, you know, it's not the family home that I think we need for four kids.
And Lexi?
It's a great house. It's just that we've got a bedroom being used as an office and we just need a bit more space downstairs.
Ed, why do you think the house doesn't work? It's just simply not big enough?
I grew up in a... thankfully, in a massive house, and I had my own space as a child. I think it's really important to have that space, you know, away from your siblings, as much as they love each other and get on really well.
Lexi, where were you brought up?
Just down the road, quite literally.
Okay.
Three-bedroom house, and I'm one of five.
So you're very used to the chaos.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I love it.
Do you feel this house will work longer term?
I do, yeah. Everything's perfectly set. The park is literally a 3-minute walk away. The school's a 10-minute walk away. The shop's obviously like a minute walk away. If I want to go on a jog, there's quite a lot of good circuits to do around here. There's lots of local parks.
But this is all about the area. What about the house?
Well, area's important.
Of course it is, but we're talking about the house.
Yeah. I just like the fact that the house is understated from the outside, so you don't realise how big it is until you come inside. And it's just a really homely feeling. And I don't think you can just, you know, you can move houses, but it might not have that same heart to it.
There is one thing, four bedrooms. You have four children.
Mm-hmm.
So, actually...
we do need one more, but two can share.
How much can you afford to spend on this house?
Given the valuation ceiling, if we were to do any work...
Yeah.
Our budget would be 60.
Okay.
We do have a bigger budget than that, but...
But you don't want to spend it unless you can prove that you're going to get it back.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. OK. I'm good with that. With your permission, we'd love to have a look around now.
No problem.
The house is currently valued at just under £300,000, and as the ceiling price for properties in this area is around £365,000, in these uncertain times, Ed and Lexi are wise to cap their renovation budget and avoid overspending to ensure any money they do invest could still be made back should they list.
I just need to make sure that every penny of their 60 grand budget will add value, as well as making it a more comfortable place to live.
Oh, look. Oh, what a sweet paint job. That looks like it's hand-painted on. I know Lexi did fashion at uni, so maybe she's an illustrator. But there is only room for the two cots and the wardrobe, and I bet you the wardrobe has got the... Yes, you see, that's the top of the stairs, so it's very narrow there. They need more space. There's no two ways about it. This room is going to be outgrown very quickly.
Oh, that's actually a really good garden. For a city house, that is fantastic and will, of course, be difficult for me to compete with. The house has already been extended, which could prove complicated if they want more space inside. Challenges are many and varied, which is just the way I like it for Kirsty.
I might struggle to compete with the homely character Lexi has here for their listed budget of £450,000, but I'm confident I can find them a more spacious, modern family home in an area they'll love.
Don't forget the 12.5 grand stamp duty and almost 6.5 in moving and legal costs. That totals nearly £19,000, which could be used to make this house work better for the whole family.
I get what Lexi's saying. This house is lovely, has a real homely feel, and this is a great view, great big garden.
It's a lovely house, but it's just not right for this big family, and I can see why Ed's had enough.
It's a pretty small family bathroom, and there is only one of them. Yeah, there's six people living in the house, so that's going to have to change.
And then this is the office. Oh, you can feel it's a bit colder. And it's not a particularly cold day today. This is the little extension above the kitchen. And it's a great home office, but, again, it's not enormous. Listen, whatever we do, we'll add value. But I'm never going to be able to add that much space.
Oh, I sense a plan brewing there.
So you've got a corridor room through there and then quite a big old...
Nobody is saying this house works. Mm. There's no point in banging on to me about...
What are you going
to
do with it, though?
I'm going to spend as little as possible on it. I'm inclined to knock through there,
yeah.
Okay, take the kitchen there, mm. and turn the current kitchen into a loo and utility. So extend a bit that way, so you'd get a downstairs...
So you put the wall back in here?
Yeah.
And have cosy TV room?
Grown-up TV room, yeah. Really nice.
What about numbers of bedrooms, though?
Numbers of bedrooms is not something I can change.
Meanwhile, they are prepared to put an extra 150 in the pot on top of the value of this as it stands.
Yeah.
In order for me to go and find another house, which I'm sure I can do, but I can tell for Lexi the access to the shops and the friends and the school, the cafes...
It's all really important.
That's super important.
Time to find out what it's going to take for Lexi and Ed to move somewhere new.
In order for you to move, what am I going to have to find?
A ginormous house with 5 bedrooms and a beautiful kitchen. And probably one more bathroom at least.
Yes, definitely. And where will it be?
We love the area where we are now. So somewhere around here would be absolutely perfect. Or this side of Nottingham is great as well.
450 is a good budget. We can find you a nice 5-bed house, couple of bathrooms, nice big kitchen. I'm not sure it'll have a garden as good as this, but let me try.
Let's see, game on.
Oh!
Lexi isn't going to give up without a fight, Phil. I hope you're ready.
I feel like now that we've talked to Kirsty and Phil, that things will move forwards, and I think it will be a really positive step, and then Ed will love the house, and then we can stay here forever.
You know what, Phil?
Mm-hmm. Tell me what.
It's hard to complain about a day like today, isn't it?
What's got into you?
I don't know, I just think...
You're very chipper.
I know. What reason is there not to be chipper?
Mum, you said it.
A positive outlook will only get you so far, Kirsty. You've got a tough job on your hands here.
In Nottingham, Lexi and Ed have been battling for nearly a year over whether to love or list their family home.
I like it, but it's too small.
But while Lex is reluctant to give up on their perfectly located Georgian semi...
I just feel like it's got so much potential. Like, so much potential.
I'm quietly confident that I'll be able to find them a bigger house with parking and within easy reach of shops and schools with their budget of £450,000.
And I have a budget of £60,000. To create more space in their current house for their growing family and convince Ed that this could still be their forever home. However, we're already dangerously close to the ceiling price of the street. And with the cost of building work escalating, shelling out for the expensive double-storey extension I suspect Lexi's hoping for would be too big a risk. So I've had to think outside the box.
So basically, I sat around this table with you, I heard you talk about your big family, and I realised that this is quite a manic room.
Yeah.
Upstairs is everyone's own private spaces. If a friend comes round, you sit now on the sofa.
Yeah.
But if you had a bigger kitchen, you'd sit in the kitchen.
Yeah.
My plan centres around opening the back of the house to create a large eat-in family kitchen. The space at the front could then be split off to create a cosy TV room. As for the much-needed second bathroom, part of the new kitchen will be a multifunctional laundry room come WC, which will be accessed via the entrance hall. And finally, while we can't create an additional room upstairs, a garden pod will provide space for Ed to work from home, freeing up one of the bedrooms so the eldest 2 children will no longer have to share.
I like the idea of that.
I worry that if you put the wall back in here, then this room will become very small.
It will become very small. Listen, Lexi, I know what you wanted. You wanted this built out here.
Yeah, yeah.
And the reason it's not there is because we can't get an agent to assure us that you'd get that money back.
Right.
Because you would be reaching the ceiling price of the street. That is a conversation for you two.
Yes, definitely.
When we first met, Ed looked me in the eye and said, I do not want to take the spending on this house beyond what it can sustain.
Yeah, that's very true.
OK, you need a chat. You might be coming back to me wanting to do more expenditure, but this is the minimum expenditure with the maximum return.
Yes.
Right, it gives you an extra bedroom, it gives you a big eat-in family kitchen with downstairs loo and utility, and you still retain a sitting room.
Yeah. OK.
Lexi is obviously disappointed. she wanted more, but I have to stay true to the fact that Ed really wants to sell this house, and they can't lose money on that. So I've got to achieve enough to keep Lexi happy while always keeping that insurance for Ed. And fighting Phil off at the same time.
I'm feeling very confident for Team Listit because I know that this plan doesn't tick all of our boxes. So let's sell it and get somewhere we actually want to be.
I like the way you're thinking, Ed. And with a budget of £450,000, I'm confident I'll be able to find a house that at least ticks a few more boxes than they're getting at home. Although Lexi seems to be doing all she can to avoid this house hunt, including spraining her ankle.
The dancing act, yeah.
Literally just dancing away and then suddenly, all I knew, my bottom was on the floor.
Well, I think you see just who you've got around you and the amount of sort of support network we've got from school, families, all the rest of it has just been, you know, really a lot more than I thought was there.
Does that mean you're wavering?
I definitely still want a five-bedroom house with two bathrooms and a drive and a garage.
Yes.
Yes. And a great community.
Well, I might not be able to do all that, but I do think this first house comes close to giving them everything they're looking for.
Here we are.
Not far from home, in the village of Calverton, is this beautiful new-build development with stunning modern houses. With off-street parking and 24% more space than they have at home, this is going to be hard to say no to.
So have you ever considered a new build?
No, not at all.
Just coming bang up to date, I think, solves all of your difficulties.
Okay.
Okay, yeah.
Are you with me so far?
It's not got quirky little features because it's a new build, so it'll be interesting to see.
It hasn't got quirky features, but your quirky features are causing you difficulties.
Yeah, that's true.
It's true, but then they are lovable, so let's see.
We'll see. Come on.
On the market for £70,000 under budget, this spectacular show home is an example of the sort of property and plot size Lexi and Ed could buy on this development, if they can get over their preconceptions about new builds. And with two reception rooms, as well as a large kitchen, diner and utility, I'm hopeful they'll see how a home like this could suit their lifestyle much more than their current house.
Come on in. Lovely big hallway. Downstairs loo, and then I hope I'm putting ticks in a few of the boxes here with a big, modern family kitchen diner. Yeah.
What's interesting is it feels not too much bigger than our place, but it's actually got everything we need in it, if that makes sense.
Yeah, I agree.
This kitchen diner is nearly three times the size of yours.
Really?
Yeah.
Right, okay.
It's got massive utility rooms. Well.
I clearly think our house is bigger than it is.
It does solve a lot of your issues.
It was a nice space.
So your budget's 450, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is on the market, or these type are on the market at just under 380.
Oh, wow.
Wow, OK.
So way under budget.
Yeah.
Would give you plenty of cash to go shopping.
That's very surprising, actually, how cheap.
Mm. Are we doing OK?
Still not quite got the community feel yet. Oh,
let's head out into the garden and we'll talk about that.
Right.
I've got a suggestion.
I know Lexi's reluctant to move away from her support network, but the truth is, even once the changes are made, with four growing kids, that house isn't going to last them much longer. So it might be time to forge some new connections elsewhere.
This is a good-sized garden.
Lexi, I know that you are very mindful of your immediate community because you're comfortable within it.
Yeah.
It just crosses my mind that in an environment like this, there aren't established kind of groups and cliques and people that have known each other for 25 years who don't need to know other people. Actually, everybody's going to want to get involved.
A bit like first day at Halls at uni.
Yeah. Yeah. Made loads of friends.
I just can't get a price still.
It's a good price, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
You haven't seen upstairs yet?
With enough space for the kids to each have their own room...
Wraps round.
What is it?
Yeah,
oh,
quite good for either Nico or Zanti, wouldn't it?
And an impressive ensuite main room.
Oh, wow, that's nice. Look at that. Could be ensuite in there, yeah. That's almost the same size, isn't it? Look at that.
This house is far more suited to their needs than theirs ever could be.
I think this is too small.
But they don't seem convinced.
Oh, this room's a bit tiny. If you put a bed in here, it'd be pretty much to where you are now. You wouldn't get a wardrobe in or anything.
Hi.
Hiya.
Hello.
Now, you guys gave me the challenge of, could I find a ginormous house with extra bedrooms and extra bathrooms? Bit of parking, under budget.
Yeah.
How did I do, Lexi?
It is under budget, and actually, I do like the new build more than I thought I would.
OK.
However, the bedrooms don't sort out the situation, because there's still a room that's too small that one of them's still going to grow out of pretty quickly.
OK. Given that you have got quite a lot more room in the budget, we could find you a bigger, better new build. If it was closer to your current community, would that make a difference?
I still do have that thought of a lot of new builds are done in big phases. Do you forever live on a building site?
How about if we were to find a modern build, so not necessarily a new build, but something that was modern in an established development? You could then assess the community. There wouldn't be building works. Would that make you more comfortable?
That would certainly make me feel a lot more comfortable, yeah.
It's OK, don't worry, Lexi, I can work around it. It's not a problem. You just sit up there on the fence. Eventually it'll get painful.
We'll see.
We'll leave it there. That is a really strong option for them, but as things stand, I'm afraid Lexi is a lady not for turning. But they do have real problems at home that they're just not going to be able to solve. So, at some point, practicality must win out over desire to simply stay where they are in their immediate community. Hope it happens sooner rather than later.
Nice try, Phil, but I don't think Lexi's going to give up on their characterful home that easily. Back at home, after 4 months of deliberations, work has finally started on the new garden pod. But the plan for inside the house has been scaled back.
Obviously, with life being post-pandemic, the price of everything's rising, all the rest of it, it's meant that we've had to change what we've decided to do. So we've done what will make our house more livable for us right now.
So they'll complete the garden pod as planned, which will allow Ed to move his office space outside, freeing up a bedroom for Xanthi to have her own space. And while they no longer have the budget for the kitchen extension, utility and WC on my original plan, Ed and Lexi still hope to make better use of their current space by installing new storage in the lounge, turning it into a multifunctional room for the whole family. They'll also block off the side door in what's currently the play area and reinstate the original narrow dining space. By cutting back on the build, they can now afford to address another of Ed's bugbears and are going to drop the curb to create a driveway.
I'm still very much team list it because I think that even with everything we're doing, even though we're freeing up a bedroom with the garden pod, we're still going to need to have a bigger house.
Now the interior work is scaled back, you might have more of a chance, Pip.
If something amazing comes up, then Phil might be in with a good chance.
Nice one, Lexi. I'm hoping that means you might be more open to the idea of modern houses and possibly even a new area.
Don't push your luck, Phil.
I'm excited to see where we're going today.
I'm excited to show you, actually. What did you say? A ginormous house. That was it, wasn't it?
Let's see if it even exists.
Oh, you need to have more faith in me, Lexi. For my second offering, I'm taking them to see this modern, four-bedroom family home in an established community just 2.5 miles from where they currently live.
Community is really active. They have street parties, the kids play in the street. This is a cul-de-sac, no passing through traffic. And, of course, importantly, Lexi, we are 2.5 miles from home.
I'll give you that. Let's see the inside first.
It looks nice on the outside.
Come on.
Built just 8 years ago, this house offers all the convenience of a modern design without the hassle of living in an ongoing development. The ground floor includes a cosy lounge and a spacious kitchen diner that's 36% bigger than what they have at home. There's also the utility and WC this family of six really need. And with a guide price of £380,000, it's well under budget.
Yeah, this is massive.
It's big, isn't it?
Yeah, that's huge. It genuinely is. This is actually impressive with the extension.
Yeah. I like the layout as well. It is all one room open plan, but you still have that separation of the kitchen, the diner and the living space as well, which makes it, you know, feels like you split it all out.
Lexi?
Yeah, it actually does feel like we'd all fit in this space. Let's see what the rest of the house has got to offer, though.
OK. It does have a little treat for Ed.
OK.
Ooh. You head through that door. Go and have a look. Okay.
In addition to all that open-plan living space, in the adjoining garage, there's also a smart office that would be perfect for Ed working from home.
Ah, it's a little office.
That was a surprise. That actually was a surprise. Yeah. I expected it to be just there.
So it was a garage, and the front half of the garage is still through that door.
Yeah.
So their bikes and their storage and everything is there.
Right.
I saw this and I just thought of you.
Yes. Perfect.
There are only four bedrooms upstairs.
Yeah.
But there are two bathrooms and there's a downstairs loo.
Okay.
Given that you've got the office, arguably you don't need the fifth bedroom.
Yeah.
The guide price is 380 to 400.
Okay.
Wow, okay. That's reasonable again.
But it doesn't have five bedrooms.
No, it doesn't. There's a garage and an office.
Yeah.
Come,
nearly win them all.
Come on.
Lex is obviously looking for problems here. But given everything we're trying to balance out on this search, with workspace, modern living and access to a community of young families, at some point, she's going to have to adjust her expectations.
So it's got the ensuite, I think, hasn't it? Oh, yeah.
And at £70,000 under budget, I think they could easily make this work.
It's a nice room, but it's just not big enough.
Although they don't seem to be sharing my optimism at the moment.
If we do go for a four bed, then what we need is for the fourth bedroom to be split or to be shared so that the twins can share, or whoever.
Mm.
And at the minute, none of these rooms are big enough for that, are they?
Not at all.
Perhaps that fifth bedroom is more important than I anticipated. But what else would they be willing to compromise on?
How are you getting on?
Yeah. Had a good look round upstairs.
Yeah. Did it score points?
Oh, Phil.
Have I done so well? Lexi, come on, Ed. We need stronger defence.
It's close. It's very close.
So we have sorted the community.
Yeah.
And we have sorted the ground floor layout.
Yeah.
But I need to work hard on the bedrooms.
Yeah.
And stay in budget. Amongst all the other different things that you found. OK, no, that's fine, I understand. This is a learning process.
Yeah.
And you do have a bit more in the budget. Let's see what we can get.
OK.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. I'm getting there. They're making me work hard, but that's absolutely fine. That's what I'm here to do. I want to help them through this. And I now know much more about what it's going to take to convince Lexi to list it. And I'm going to find it.
For me, I think for the next property, it needs to have the extra bedroom, and I think if it was a bit of an older property, that'd be nicer. If it's not, then fair enough, but I think that's what I'd be looking towards, and preferably closer to our area.
I think you might need to do a bit of expectation management here, Phil, because Lexi's not letting go of that wish list anytime soon.
It's almost like when you used to try and get a flight, right? Every time you refresh the web page, the price went up, and that's what it feels like now, just with, you know, quotes in general.
In Nottingham, Ed and Lexi have been forced to scale back the plan for their four-bed family home.
I think even with the changes that we make, we're still in a position where we're going to very quickly outgrow this house.
And even Lexi's tempted to give up on the house she's loved for 4 years.
I do love this house, but at the same time, if something amazing comes up, then Phil might be in with a good chance.
But just because they can't go ahead with all of my original plan due to escalating costs, that doesn't mean things are over for Team Lovett. So I'm popping in to rally the troops and offer a fresh perspective.
So I'm back in Nottingham and the sun is out, which makes it the perfect weather for looking at garden pods. Hopefully, at some point, there's going to be some off-street parking here as well. But for the time being, I want to see what's happening out back.
While my plan for the inside has been scaled back, Lexi and Ed are still going ahead with my garden pod idea, and it's looking splendid.
It's enormous! I might be inclined to put a window in that end for a bit more light. It's always difficult to see until the doors and windows are put in.
The supersized pod is going to be split in two, so that Lexi has a dedicated space to craft with the kids, as well as Ed getting his own office. To make the most of their two additional garden rooms, Lexi and Ed have wisely chosen to install proper heating and insulation. So the total cost for the pod is coming in at around £20,000. And given that it will free up a bedroom and clear some of the kids' craft supplies from the living room, I think it's great value for money.
What's going to happen inside?
Not as much as I'd hoped, quite frankly, just because of costs.
Yeah.
We didn't mind spending, say, 10 grand more, mm-hmm. if it would be worth it for the family overall.
Yeah.
But as it was more like 30.
No.
So basically, we've just decided that we're just going to make it a livable space for us and potentially see how that works for us.
So do you want to go in and talk about how best to... Yeah, good.
Yes.
Let's go and have a look.
OK.
Lexi and Ed are going ahead with my suggestion to add storage for the kids' toys in what will be the new lounge playroom. So the priority is now the new kitchen diner. Once the side door is blocked off, they'll have more usable space. But my concern is that this 2.2-metre-wide room is just too narrow to accommodate the whole family with their existing dining table.
There is no doubt that you've got to be able to push that table back against the wall.
Yeah.
So you'd have a high chair at either end. The table needs to be as long as possible.
Yes.
And also where do you put the fridge?
Well...
Right.
Mm. It's a bit far from the kitchen, I grant you, but it's...
Still does the job and it's in the same room at least.
Yes, yes. So that's a possibility, to put the fridge here, and then this means that you basically have the space to walk in here. Your table does not need to be wide, and it is much cheaper to... You're going to be getting the builders in anyway. You create a table from scaffolding boards table, okay, or depends how rustic you want it.
Yeah, yeah.
But, you know, you make your... You absolutely... You do not think about trying to find a table that fits this space. You make the table to fit the space. That is where you're going to save the money.
Yeah.
Standard slim dining tables typically measure 90 cms wide, but custom making something narrower would make it much easier to manoeuvre around this room with four children. And while I'm here, I have one more idea that will add storage and make the most of every inch of space.
Have you ever seen when people put glass shelves in windows and then put glasses on them?
No, but that sounds nice.
Looks really nice. You obviously don't want to store anything here which is going to block the light.
No.
But you could do it, and also coloured glasses and candlesticks.
That'd be amazing.
It would look like a really special space.
Yeah. No, I like that. I think it's a really good idea.
I think Lexi and possibly even Ed are starting to get excited about this build again. Job done.
So many people are now finding the work that they wanted to do unaffordable. And that has made it more likely that Lexi will want to move. But I still think we've got a chance to crack it with some clever storage and some lateral thinking.
And 5 weeks later, things are really moving along. Despite scaling back on the original plan, there's a lot going on. The curb has been lowered. The garden pod now has windows in both sides, like I suggested, and the electrics are due to be fitted. The external walls of Ed's former office are also being rendered, so it's better insulated for when it becomes a bedroom again. While these cost-effective changes are bound to make a huge difference, Lexi still has her heart set on that extension.
I'm still trying to find a way to get it in there. If I can find it at a decent price, we'll be doing it.
Yeah.
It'll be like round two.
But let's be realistic. To make this house the size they really need would require a drastic overspend. And that's not something either of us would recommend. So I've got one last chance to deter them from taking that risk and show Lexi that her perfect house does exist elsewhere. And I think I might have nailed it with this 12-year-old, five-bedroom, four-bathroom home that's walking distance from where they currently live.
So, my final throw of the dice. We are 1 mile from home.
Yep.
Yeah.
I have
tried to pull out all the stops with this. This is an absolute cracker, and it does have 5 bedrooms.
It actually looks like quite a nice house.
It actually looks like a nice house you brought me to. Come on, let me show you around.
A promising start, and I can't wait to see their reaction to what's inside. On the market for £475,000, it's slightly over budget. But with a vast kitchen diner and a spacious lounge, this house is almost double the size of theirs. 5 good-sized bedrooms set across the first and second floor mean the children could each have their own space. And with an ensuite main room, a ground floor toilet, and 2 family bathrooms, they would never have to argue over the loo again.
Come on in. Just pop your heads in that room.
Wow, this is massive.
This is a good-sized room, isn't it? Good storage.
And then come through. There's 5 really strong bedrooms and 3 bathrooms plus the downstairs loo.
Wow.
I think it's everything that your house can't be. But...
fighting talk.
It comes at a cost.
Right, OK.
It's £25,000 over budget. So it's £475,000. The owners of the house have found a house that they wish to buy, and they are super, super keen to do a deal on this.
Right, OK.
Right, OK.
But what do you make of it? Go on, shoot from the hip.
It's a really good-sized kitchen diner. Yeah, and it is nice.
You can't hear the road from here as well.
Don't hear it at all, do you?
Which I'm very surprised about, actually. Yeah.
Very good indeed. Let's see outside first. So we've got a beautiful south facer for you here.
Massive, isn't it?
And actually, it's well-designed for children as well.
I want you to see the bedrooms, because they're fantastic. But before you go out there, there was a little surprise across the way. You go and have a look across there.
OK, perfect. After you.
If they like the garage at that last house, they're going to love this one.
Oh, wow, that's a good
size, isn't it?
It's not connected to the house, but it's fully insulated and fitted with electrics, so seriously stands up to their new garden pod at home.
You could even make part of it an office. You could probably knock through there into the garden, make it accessible from there. I don't know if you could do that.
No, it's I think it's nice as it is.
It's loads of space.
Yeah. I'm impressed.
I'm getting the sense that Lexi can actually see herself living here. But it's the bedrooms that have been the biggest sticking point in the past, so I'm hoping they're happy with what the top 2 floors have to offer here.
Oh, wow.
All right, yeah, it hooks all the way around. And look, the ensuite.
Oh, wow, yeah. And it's a really good-sized room. Actually bigger than ours.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? Yeah.
And it's got a bit more wardrobes. Yeah.
Things seem to be going very well for Team Listed.
Yeah, it's massive in here, isn't it?
Yeah, I am impressed. Oh, that's filled on.
And you doubted me all this time, Lexi.
This is even bigger.
Yeah, this is a really good-sized room, actually. You could happily put 2 kids in here while they're small.
Yeah, but then if you don't want the office in the garage...
Or if you notice...
Yeah.
You could even easily have an office space out there.
Yeah, you could put... Oh, yeah, it's nice and light. You get natural light, you put a little fold-down table at the end.
Yeah.
And then you don't have to take up a bedroom.
No.
That's the kind of creative thinking we like on Team Listed.
I thought I'd find you up here.
Hey.
Yeah.
It's really big up top, isn't it?
It's definitely ticked all the boxes. We can definitely grow into a house of this size. Feels very homely as well.
Mm.
Yeah, actually, that's true. I think the nice thing here is there is actually detail. So, like, around the doors, there's details and nice little things that make it not feel like a new build.
Mm. Hopefully you can see now that there is life outside of your road.
Yes, yes, most definitely.
Good.
Yeah.
Definitely. Let's leave it there. Can we still be friends?
Yeah, all right then.
I'm fine. Kirsty loves to remind me that pride comes before a fall. But given they've had to scale back their plans at home, which means that they're simply not going to be able to solve their issues, added to which I've been able to show them around a house like this, must surely mean Team Lister has got it in the bag.
Yeah, I think overall Phil has done a good job on the search, and we'll have some words later.
And I think it's certainly made you think a bit more, hasn't it, about Team Listed?
Sort of.
But don't count your chickens too soon, Pip. Just wait until you get a look at this transformation back at home.
In Nottingham, it's been 10 months since we first met Lexi and Ed. and it's finally time to find out whether they've decided to love or list their 1920s semi.
Well, I know you've got Ed an office in the garden.
Yeah, which is great.
And that was the bit that was driving him mad, and that was probably the main bit why he wanted to leave.
Yes.
These are posh new houses.
There's lots of posh new houses, and I was able to show them, actually, new houses on the search.
Were you?
Yeah.
What they've done is great.
Starting with dropping the curb to create a driveway to resolve the parking situation, which was another of Ed's major issues. But Phil's more interested in what I'm wearing.
You are taking things to the next degree, aren't you?
I know.
And the scarf, it's beautiful.
Hand-knitted in Norway.
I should make more of an effort.
Yeah, you should, to be fair.
Hello.
Hello.
Look at you two.
How are you doing?
How are you doing? Would you like to come on in?
I'd love to come on in.
Loved it.
Escalating building costs meant they couldn't go ahead with my original plan for an extension. But by blocking off the side door and freeing up space in what was the old playroom, Lexi and Ed have still managed to create a kitchen diner with space for the whole family.
I don't think you've even got a new sink. Just new taps to go with the hardware on the doors and a repainted kitchen.
That works really well, because that was a very busy playroom, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it works really well. Yeah. And there is going to be a really beautiful set of shelves in the window with all the glasses in.
Which is definitely still coming.
Slight hiccup with a tape measure.
Yeah.
Blocking up the door is actually a masterstroke, because it, again, has taken pressure off everything.
Yeah.
And by moving the dining table in here, out of what was the lounge diner, they've made a more comfortable living space and play area, with new bespoke storage units keeping the children's toys out of sight in the evenings.
Actually feels really, really huge.
It does.
And the unit, such a difference.
The whole room just feels massive now.
There was a dining table. That was quite busy up that end of
the room. Yeah. And it's no longer that. It's more of a proper living space where we can chill out with the children.
The whole process has been about changing one room to free up and relieve the pressure on a different room.
Sort of simple changes bring quite big results. However, your real problems were lack of fifth bedroom and lack of a bathroom.
Yes.
Which hasn't changed.
No.
Obviously.
But, you know, the house is still 10 times better than it was.
10 times?
10 times.
Spending just £15,000 within the house, Ed and Lexi have managed to completely transform every room and make better use of the space they already had. Upstairs, the exterior of Ed's cold former office has been rendered to provide better insulation. And it's been completely redecorated as a beautiful new bedroom for Xanthi, so she no longer has to share with her brother. Meanwhile, Ed has moved his office outside into one half of the new £20,000 garden pod.
So what have we got down here?
Oh, I'm so excited to see this.
By fully insulating the pod and installing electrics and heating, they've created two additional rooms and gained 21 square metres of living space. So while Ed can work peacefully on one side, on the other, Lexi and the kids can craft to their heart's content, and the clutter stays completely out of the house.
Look, you've got your slippers under the table.
Yeah.
Is it going well? Everybody enjoying it?
The kids absolutely love using the space and drawing and painting and everything in there.
Yeah.
Again, it takes pressure off the house.
Yes, definitely.
Doesn't give you a fifth bedroom. Just saying.
Well, bedrooms are just for sleeping in.
I think we'd better get on with this.
Right, Phil, this is the bit where you usually tell us about the wildly successful viewings you had.
I like to think that I did prove beyond reasonable doubt that it is possible within a mile of this house to buy the space that you dreamt of.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, definitely.
It's doable.
Yeah.
And I love what you've done here. And you've absolutely taken pressure off the house for now. But is it really a long-term solution?
It's still a great house. It does what we need it to right now. And the kids love it.
This might be the moment to mention.
Go on, give us the news.
Average pre-renovation valuation, £282,500.
How much did you spend?
£35,000.
Yes.
Average post-renovation value, £340,000. Value added, £57,500. Yeah. Value added minus spend, £22,000.
That's very good.
Yeah, that's really good.
That is really good.
Yeah.
Because usually, if you don't add any space on, you just do a rejig, you shouldn't lose money, but you're not going to make money.
That was one of the big things we didn't want to overstretch what we could get out of the house. So to hear that
makes me happy.
Which brings us to the point.
Right. Lexi, Ed, do you want to love it?
Or do you want to list it?
We are going to stay here and enjoy the house, but ultimately list it.
So you'll enjoy it for a bit because it's all new and fresh.
Yeah.
And then move.
It's been a long journey here and something we should have started a long time ago. But as you've pointed out a lot, it still doesn't meet the needs of our family.
Of our family, yeah. Mm.
For now, it does. It's just as they get older and they start fighting for the bathroom, yeah. I think that's going to be an issue.
It's looking tip-top.
You've done a really great job. It's a special house.
I'm happy with what we've done.
100%. Kids love their bedrooms. The unit and the skinnier table have just really made a huge difference.
For me, Phil showing us the new builds has been really useful. It's opened our eyes to what we could have had.
I'll always have my eye out just in case there's an extension on the cheap.
A victorious Bloody Mary.
Yes.
Indeed. How about that?
I will concede that it is a good thing that you have one son, because otherwise people would get a bit bored.
There are people who say to me on the street every day, oh, Phil, you never win. Well, to them I say, 4-2 to me. Cheers.
Cheers.
If you'd like our help deciding whether to love it or list it, apply online at channel4.com/takepart. Next time, I'm travelling solo. Back to catch up with Catherine and Nigel in Larn.
It is a bit of the wow factor now.
It is a bit of the wow factor. But all is not as I left it.
Hot tub area. Yes.